How do you feel about Errol Spence saying that if you won, that you and him should do it, if you're not ducking anybody? Well, he tweeted that.
I don't duck nobody. Bro, I don't duck nobody. Like I said before, Al Haim is the manager. You want to fight? Let's fight. I'm a fighter. That's what I do. I fight. I fought everyone they ever put in front of me. I fought. I never said no to no one.
Why do you think the fans keep continuing to harp on that? Not just you, but me? Just the welterweights in general are all avoiding Spence. Do you feel that's true?
I don't think nobody's avoiding him. I think you got to understand, no fighter makes his own matches in boxing. No fighter makes his own matches. Boxing is handled by managers and other people like that. But like I said before, it's a fight. This is eventually gonna happen. Everybody's gonna fight everybody, just like everybody. That's how I fought Thurman. You feel me?
Well, like when you fought Matisse, everyone said you weren't gonna fight him.
Exactly. Yeah. So it's always gonna be that. And then if it's not him, it's gonna be a newcomer. Mm-hmm. It's gonna be another guy that's coming up that people are saying you're scared to fight. That's just the boxing game. It's always gonna be somebody new. I can't fight everybody at one time.
Do you feel Keith is that the one you want the most of, or is there a fight that you want more in particular just because you want that get back, or is it more the show?
Yeah, I feel like I have to avenge that loss, you feel me? But I'm not desperate. Mm-hmm. Danny Garcia is not desperate for no fight, you understand? Because at the end of the day, I'm the one that packed the seats at the Barclays Center. I'm the one who got all the views, so.
They keep calling you out, right? So they keep calling you out.
Yeah, exactly.
You
keep promoting me.
Okay, what do you do right now?
Are you going on vacation, man?
I'm going to sleep. Yeah. I'm going to sleep with my daughter.
Hey, Danny.
Let's go.
What's up, Johnny?
How you doing, man?
I'm always good. How are you?
I straight the game.
You live for this, boy. You like Michael Jackson. Once you get in the ring,
one, you should be on that show. One.
But every time you do it, you do the same thing. You take care of your business. You know when it's going to come. I tell you what, I ain't know either, but nobody knew. Because if I do find a little girl, good little fight for you, but you bam, on the button.
No, in the new day, he came to fight.
Don't play. Yeah. He came, it was a great fight.
Yeah.
And you put your game plan down, ain't you?
Hey,
you got a game plan now, man. You do your job, brother. You ain't right. You just ain't there. You in there. You in there fight with your son.
What did Paulie tell you? You're poison?
No, he said I was poised the whole way. But I am poison.
You got poison.
You get the hair like a basketball player.
But
I just
got to do it.
I watch
your
thing, y'all.
No, you're like painting in
our hair. Hey, Angel, man. Motherfucker, Angel said, we love you.
What
the fuck? Watch out, boy. I'm busting your face.
Damn, you gonna see him.
But I don't need all of him.
What do you mean?
Marcus.
Erica, were you nervous at all during the fight?
I gotta go.
No. Before the fight starts, I get nervous. But once he's in the ring, I don't get very nervous.
Hey, Spencer. Come here, Joey. Quick.
Well, excuse me. I think they're doing that.
Ricky, what did you think of the fight tonight?
I'm just glad that
y'all mentioned.
I'm glad that Brandon's safe.
Did you get it?
I told you it was bad.
I told you.
Hey, this is called down to my doggy with the best interview in the world. What do you think about the fight today?
It was a great fight. People said it was a mismatch, but it was a great fight. A great night of boxing. And
how did you have the rounds before they stopped it? How did you have the fight?
I thought it. Tell me where to follow you really quick.
Dynamite TKO. D-Y-N-A-M-I-T-E. TKO on Twitter. On Twitter is Dynamite KO.
Fresh. A lot of people just think I wasn't buying Dynamite.
I love it. How's your dad doing? He's doing good. He's back at home waiting on me now.
Yeah,
I know. I already missed the gym Thursday and Friday.
All right. You want
this one? Sorry. Come on, bud. Come on. Hey. Hey, Saul. Did you Saul? What?
Yeah. Get it, get it, get it!
with Danny.
I heard Saul fight her.
She good dance.
I get it, Nick. I get it. When she get in her bag, it's like.
Wait.
How old is she now?
She's 2.
Does she talk at all?
Okay.
What did you think? What did you think of the fight?
Nope, she don't come back.
She in her bag.
Did she watch the fight too? What did she think?
Hey. She's looking at her dad. Let me see. Go ahead, let me see. Okay.
Watch out for the Showtime crew.
Come on. Oh.
Did you know Sean was going to go in the ring? Because he told me a few weeks ago he's going to do it.
Man, I don't even know why I let him up there. They should have Kevin Hart his ass. I said, no.
No, I think the plan was for him to be up there.
Right.
Good night tonight. We had a great night. How much did you win?
Just a couple hundred bucks.
I should have listened to you.
I know. I should have.
I told you. I saw you at that book.
Nah, he's been great. Been working his ass off. You know, he's a great kid. I mean, you heard what he said to Rios. You know,
yeah.
Danny's a class act.
What did Danny Garcia tell Brian Rios after the fight?
You know, he just basically told him to keep his head up and not worry about like what the haters say, because Danny's been a champion for years, and no matter what he says, you know, they always give him a tough time regardless. And you just can't worry about that, because they're not putting their gloves on. Danny is, you know what I mean?
Danny, last thing. Why did you tell Brandon to keep his head up and ignore the haters?
Hey, they talked about Jesus, and he was perfect. That tells you everything, right?
It's true. And you dealt with that your whole career, too.
My whole career, wow. It can't break me. I came too far.
And you keep proving them wrong.
Exactly. I overcame adversity. So I know where I stand. So.
And last out to the fans in Philly. Danny, what do you want to tell everybody?
Oh, I love the Philly. I told you I was going to follow up after the Eagles, and I did it.
Danny, did you pick the music in between rounds? It was Meek Mill every round.
Yeah, we got a rap. Free Meek Mill.
Angel, you're driving back to Philly?
Yeah, I'm driving back to Philly. Yeah, yo, we should have got that.
Appreciate
that. Hold on, Jeff. I hold that would have been the 2000 belt, the 2000
fight. You would have gotten a trainer.
Yo, that's your diamonds on. That's your $40,000 belt. So I'm happy for the people that's had, they're getting that belt in March. That belt. I know some kids are fighting for that belt. The 2000 belt for the WBC.
That's true, right? Yep.
That joint, $45,000. I wanted that joint home. I'll see you guys later. Right. Love you guys. Right.
Thank you. Thanks. Sorry. You okay?
And the former two-division world champion who put on an excellent performance tonight, none other than Danny Garcia. Thank you. First of all, I want to thank God for this victory. I want to thank my dad, Team Garcia, and everyone who came out to watch the fight. Hey, Brandon, don't worry about the critics, bro. I was champion for 5 years, and they still come here. They still talk shit about me. Until somebody could do what you do, bro, fuck them. You don't want putting that blood, sweat, and tears in there, risking your life in the ring, so nobody can tell you not, bro. Keep your head up.
Respect to that, man. Respect.
But as far as the fight, it was a tough fight. I knew Brandon was gonna come to fight. He trained hard for this fight. You know, it's an opportunity for him to show the world that, you know, he's still a top fighter. It was a good fight until the fight ended. Me and my pop had a good game plan, you know, stand in front of him a little bit, move a little bit, and we did it, and we got the job done. And that's basically how that went.
Questions? Garcia, you know that you're usually a slow starter, but Reels being in front of you the whole time, you basically had to work from the get-go. What'd you feel about that?
I knew he was going to be in front of me. He's a tough vet. He's a good inside fighter. He had a better jab than I thought he had. He had a pretty good jab with a good timing. He worked good on the inside. But, you know, we knew what he was going to do, so we just had to stay composed and just follow the game plan till the fight was over.
Danny, how were you able, it seemed like he wanted to establish his pressure, and then this may be for Dad as well, how were you able to calm the fight down and fight at your tempo, and he wanted to I saw him trying to create traps for you, and you just slowed him down. How do you do that?
I just use my lateral movement. I try to use my jab to the head, jab to the body. I try to stay tight on the inside and just offset his timing, his pressure. So I think we did a good job of that. I think he did a good job of fighting on the inside and putting pressure. And we just followed the game plan.
Danny, congratulations on your victory tonight. You are known for your left hook, but you use your right hand a lot in this fight. Was that something that you used specifically for this fight? It's just how the fight went, or are you planning to use it more going forward?
Yeah, in sparring, I noticed, you know, when you find a guy who's coming forward, it's good to just throw a lot of straight right hands and a lot of punches straight down the middle because they're coming straight towards you. So I was trying to throw the straight right hand, and I was trying to use the jab to the head, jab to the body, and then it worked good every time I did it.
Danny, you fought Eric Morales before, so you fought a Mexican champion before, but with Rios tonight, with the pressure and the inside fighting, did you feel like tonight, more than any other night, you knew what it was like to be in there with a real Mexican fighter?
Oh, definitely. I would say to this day, that first Morales fight, I think that was one of my hardest fights. Because I was young, he was experienced, he had a lot of tricks up his sleeve. But definitely, those... the Mexican fighters with skill who come forward, that was a tough fight for anybody.
Danny, great performance tonight. So just talk a little bit about that border interaction. You seem kind of heated. You know, I think that's the first time you really show that type of emotion post-fight when you just got done putting in 9 rounds of work with Brandon.
I mean, it's the day I told him it's the Danny Garcia show. He didn't want to listen. He said I was in his backyard, but I told him he's from Ohio. So I'm like, I think he took too much punches, bro. Not in your backyard. But it is what it is. I don't know, man. I don't know what's in his head. It was like the Kevin Hart situation when he tried to go on stage in the Super Bowl. I was like, bro, bad timing, baby. I love Kevin Hart though, but it's the Eagles' time to shine. You feel me? And that was my moment.
Danny, what's next for you now? Because you had
where's the question coming from?
You had Sean Porter in the ring. You had Errol Spence tweeting at you. You going all different directions. What kind of direction are you looking to head into now?
You know, it's whatever. At the end of the day, it's whatever. I know how the game works. You could want to fight who you want to fight, and it never happened. So, whoever they put in front of me, like my whole career, you know, if it's the Thurman fight again, if not, I fight somebody else. The Spence, Porter, I fight somebody else. Whatever happens, happens. I don't care. I'm a fighter. This is what I do. I've been fighting for 20 years. I've been fighting since I was a little kid. I fought the best fighters in the amateurs. I fought the best fighters in the pro. It's not new to me.
Right here, Danny. When's the last time you had a shot that clean to end the fight? Do you remember?
Ross Elko, saying on this game. wait, was it that fight? Name, it was that fight. Shit, it was that fight. Sad to say.
Anybody else? Oh, one more here.
Andrew, what'd you think of the way he came back? He hadn't fought in a while, and how do you think you responded? And as far as following the game plan and being sharp, what did you think?
No, Danny, you know, part of the game plan, I mean,
he threw himself off a little bit, and Brandon was coming in because I didn't want that. I wanted Danny to dominate him on the clinches and all that, because Brandon's good at that. He know how to use his head, he know how to clinch, he know how to, you know, pity pat. And that'll take a fight and frustrate you. But I knew how to keep Danny in the fight. Because if I would have let him slip out the fight, I couldn't have brought him back. So I try to keep him in the fight. I told him, stay composed and don't let him do that to you. Dominate him. You do what you want to do. So I'm glad he listened. He was dropping his hand a little bit, his left hand. He's trying to hit him with overhand right. You know, we worked on all that. We worked on leaning left, straight right hand down the pipe. Because Brandon's right there. So, you know, he did at the end, he did what he needed to do. It was a great fight. You got to understand, Brandon no slouch. He's got 35 wins, brother, 25 KOs with 3 losses. That's a record. And you got to respect anybody like that. So we never took him lightly. So we knew he was going to come to fight. And we know we got to fight because Danny's 33-1. That one is predictable. That shit was like, that shit was some suspect shit. You know what I mean? There's a lot of politics with that bullshit calling racist and all that shit. They fucking racist. You know what I mean? And this bullshit got to stop with the boxing shit. They putting the boxers down and all that. And he said earlier, it's about you guys. MMA don't do that shit. And they be having 5 wins and 10, 20 losses. And they still stars. And they still making commercials. What the fuck? And then the boxers get nada. They get bullshit. They get a finger. You're a bum. Fuck that. Ain't no fucking bums. Takes a lot of work to come up here. Motherfuckers that talk the shit in the got. Never took a shot in the tip of the nose. That's what happens. They were bullied as kids. They took their money, but I did. I took their money. Good, brother. God bless y'all, bro.
Thank you, guys. Thanks, everybody. Lana's gonna close.
Thank you, everyone, for coming out. What a great night of boxing. Give these two great warriors a hand. One note too before we leave, I want to acknowledge Joe Spencer for putting on a great performance tonight at Grand Rapids Mission.
Listen, your haters are on your side. I always remember, without your haters, they won't buy no tickets. They don't want to buy the tickets. Don't worry about that. You still can get somebody some work. All right? You be good, bro. Enjoy your money and relax. All right, bro.
San Antonio.
So, Danny. Dan. We're down to the final four, y'all. We're down to the final four.
Next one. Thank you. I know. I think you shouldn't have did on the rope. I want that. You know, you give him a little respect on the rope, but it's okay, boxing. Sometimes you plan shit, don't go the way you plan it. Sometimes you gotta adjust. That's when you know when you got a real trainer, when you adjust to the shit. So you stay composed. Because I never wanted them to get out there. If I would have let him get out the fight, it would have been, and then he would have been raising up his hand. So I kept him in the fight. We worked on all that shit.
What do you want to see? What do you want to see next round?
Well, I want to see the best for him. I want the best fight for Danny. Danny, young. I don't want to fight Danny when he's old. I want Danny to retire.
My chin, I brought it back down to my stomach and he called me like a dumbass. It was a learning experience for myself, a rookie mistake, and what else can I say? But I felt that I was above on points and I felt I was in the fight. Okay, your turn.
No, my performance, like I said, I felt great, I felt strong, I wasn't even tired or nothing like that, I felt really good and I felt in perfect shape. Like I said though, it was just the fact that I threw a lazy jab, he came over and he caught me, and what else can I say, you know. I think I got up too fast, it was a rookie mistake, I've never been knocked down before, so I reacted too fast, I got up and I was a little wobbly, and my corner felt that I was hurt, but
I didn't think I was hurt. I could have still continued. Maybe if he would have knocked me down again, then they could have all fuck, he's really hurt, dropped me. But like I said, every warrior goes to it. Everybody's been dropped down before. Every fighter, especially warriors, look at Arturo Gatti, look at Mickey Ward, look at fucking Julio Cesar Chavez, look at fucking Josito Lopez. He's been dropped. Everybody, Madonna's been dropped. All these people have been dropped. They get back up, they still compete. And I felt I could still compete. And I felt I was still in the game. Like I said, I think in my heart, I was above on points. Did Danny land some good shots? Yes. He got power? Yes. He has pop? Yes. But I think I was still above on points, maybe like a round. And it was a really close fight, but until the stoppage happened, you know, fuck. I'm just mad because of that shit happened. Not only that, I'm mad because they didn't give me opportunity to try to finish the fight, the round. I had like probably like 30, 40 seconds left. That's enough time, you know, I could have, by the time they said break in, you could have grabbed, you could have moved around, you could have run around, whatever you could have done. And it would have killed time, but it is what it is. It's a court decision. They made a decision what they made. And what can I say, man? I think, to me, in my heart, in my mind, I think more of a love guy involved than a boxer trainer, which is good because they love me and I know they're watching out for me, but I think that's what happened. It was more of a love instead of a boxing trainer that happened.
Robert, what'd you make of the fight up to that point?
I think Brandon was fighting a good fight. You know, that's Brandon's style, and he was coming in, you know, fighting the way he normally fights. You know, we said it before, you know, we were hoping that, you know, into the later rounds, Brandon was gonna take advantage of those rounds, and I think that's what he was doing. But like he's saying, he got caught, and it just happens in boxing. That's part of boxing.
Do you agree with him about the love
part? Well, look, right now he's hurt because it's a fight that he didn't want to lose, and he really trained hard, and he was motivated, and you know, he did everything right, and that's probably what hurts him the most. But you know, I do love Brandon, and I really don't want to see him get hurt. I gotta go back and see the fight again. I was telling the inspectors I need the fight stopped, but you know, the inspectors are telling me you're the one that has to jump in. But if I'm not mistaken, by the time I jumped in, Kenny Bayless had already stopped it. I don't know if you guys could maybe prove, you know, tell me that I'm wrong or something, or maybe let Brandon understand that maybe the ref had already stopped it before I stepped in.
No, not really, because like I said, man, I trained my ass off for this fight. You know, I really wanted, I trained my fucking ass off, you know, and it just put more milk in on the table, you know what I mean? People gonna talk more shit like always, you know, and I'm just mad because, like I said, I thought I was in the fight. I thought I was above a point. I thought it was like a part like a round. Until he called me. You know, that's what happened when you get... I threw a lazy jab. That's what happened. I threw a lazy jab and he just called me. And said, bring it back up to my chin. I brought it back to my stomach and he just fucking got a really good punch. And like I said, Danny does can... He does got pop from both hands. But I felt that I was still winning the fight. And maybe you never know. The critics, they always gonna fucking talk shit. So... that's the thing that I hate. That thing that drives me more insane, because makes me more mad, is because the fact that you motherfuckers are gonna say some stupid shit tomorrow. That's what makes me more mad. And if you know who the fuck you are, you know who the fuck I'm talking about. So that's what makes me more mad.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's give Brandon a great round of applause for a terrific fight tonight.
Turn up the volume and just sit back. You rockin' with the best, Elie Seckbach. The wave of the future, we don't lose. Tell me what you're watching, EsNews. He came a long way, all the way from Jerusalem. Heavy on the grind, competition he abusing.